to the rat dungeon. Location for my bike. The usual place I park at has increased the rates by 3 times. I went from like $4.50 a day to 12 something. Anyway, so now I am in the dungeon. Younger, I wanted to fly airplanes, so I took kind of my initial flight training in the U.S. from a this is pre 9/11, so they weren't worried about too much about foreign students. No, I took my training in the U.S. At a school, and there was a guy there who. My instructor was a former Vietnam pilot. He used to fly thuds. F-105s, Delta Dot. But my flight instructor had all these like sayings that to this day I still kind of think of when I'm riding motorcycles. You know, like one of them was fuel you don't have doesn't help, which, you know, is like it kind of translates quite well from airplanes to, you know, when you get to that gas station. And you go, well, I could probably make it to the next town, you know? I always think, well, fuel you don't have doesn't help. And he used to have, he had a whole bunch of kind of sayings like that. Another one he had was like, if you're not doing something, there's something you're not doing. Which was, I guess, supposed to make you think that, you know, if you're just like kind of like, you know, even when you kind of zone out and you're just kind of like enjoying the ride, you can become kind of complacent to the various things you should be doing on a motorcycle, the, you know, checking for traffic, lane position, all the things that you know that you should be doing, but you just start kind of like, you just start becoming a spectator to the whole thing. And that can let your guard down. Another one he had was aviate, navigate, communicate in that order. So if you don't have control of your aircraft, do that. If you have control of your aircraft, if you don't know where you are, then you should be doing that. And communication is the last thing you should be doing. You shouldn't be like talking to the ground controllers if you don't have control of your airplane or you don't know where you are or where, you know, where you're going, kind of thing. So, and that's similar for like, highly applicable to motovlogging, you know? while I'm chatting with you guys. Usually I edit them out, but if you were to play kind of like a clip of me just riding in general, you would see that a lot of the time I shut up, you know, mid-sentence, because I'm, you know, concentrating on what the hell is going on around me. He had. Altitude you don't have doesn't help. That one really doesn't translate very well. I don't know if you could think of a way that that translates to motorcycles, probably not. I guess when you get right down to it, operating vehicles is, there's a lot of crossover in how you should approach it. Maybe there is. Another random shit. Oh, I don't know if you guys have seen the Yami Noob accident. That's pretty spectacular. Pretty. I don't know. Hopefully he's all right. Heard, you know, on YouTube or whatever, there's some like comments saying that he's broken bones, but he's still kicking. That was like a very frightening accident. You know, that's another thing that, you know, it reminds me of aviation a bit is in Canada every year. I don't know if it's only Canada, but in when the weather gets shitty. You know, in the winter, people, all the pilots are kind of, they're out of practice for instrument flying, right? And that's when a lot of accidents happen, is they just don't, you know, they're just out of practice, they're just rusty, right? It's like a skill that's perishable in a way. And I think that the same sort of thing probably happens with motorcyclists. You know, you put your bike away for the winter, and then you pop it out in the summer and you go for a ride, and your skills are not quite as sharp as they were when you put it away, right? Also, you're very excited because, you know, you're out in the road finally after, you know, months of, you know, looking at the weather reports and wondering whether you can insure this thing again. And then you go out there and you know, you make a stupid rookie mistake, you know. And that's all it takes is one, really. You just have to like calm down and take it easy for a while until you get your skills back. Get your road sense going again, you know. Anyway, don't know if I have anything else to say. That's about it.